Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Bobby and you're watching Mind Island Design. Today I'm going to show you how you can easily create an ink bleed effect in Photoshop. This effect will work for both text or any images you import. Let's begin by converting our layer into a smart object and then go into Filter, Blur, and choosing Gaussian Blur. The amount of blur really depends on how much you want your ink effect to overlap or bleed into each other. Now let's go into our appearance panel and choose threshold. Here we can adjust our effect even more with the slider. If you still can't get it to look just right, you can always go back into your effects and edit the Gaussian blur. Now let's go to Filter, Distort, and choose Ripple. Here we can add some grittiness and some texture to our effect. If you want even more realism, you can create a new document the same size as your current project and import some grunge texture and then export that as a Photoshop document. Now you can go to Filter, Distort, and choose Displace. Then you will want to import the texture you just created. Mine is still a bit too harsh, so I'm going back into the texture file and playing around with the levels. Then simply disable and re-enable the effect to reset it. Now the final step is preparing this to be exported as a PNG. As you can see, when we hide the background layer, the effect does not work as the threshold needs a white background for it to work properly. So a quick workaround for this is to group our threshold and our text and then create a solid color. Then we will want to make the color black. Now if we go to Channels, hold Command or Control and click, and then go back to Layers and select our mask, then hit Command or Control and I, and that will invert our mask. You just want to do that one more time, and then hide your group. And as you can see, when we hide the background, the effect is visible. Now if you click on the solid color, you can change the color of your effect. And that is how you can easily create an ink bleed effect in Photoshop. I hope this video helped. If it did, don't forget to hit subscribe and follow us on all of our social media to stay connected and never miss a new tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.